In this example, we want to solve 5 times sine of 3x equals 2 on the given interval. While it may be tempting to perform a substitution using a sum or difference identity, or maybe even possibly a double angle identity, but these problems are much easier to solve if we just replace 3x with theta, since there's only one trig function involved in this equation. So if we take this 3x and set it equal to theta, we can solve the equation 5 times sine theta equals 2. Then once we determine theta, we can come back and solve for x. So let's go ahead and divide both sides by 5. We want to solve the equation sine theta equals 2/5. Now this sine function value of 2/5 is not going to result in a nice reference triangle, so we'll have to determine theta by using our graphing calculator. So if we take inverse sine of both sides, on the left side, we're left with theta, and on the right side, we have inverse sine 2/5. So now we'll go to our calculator and determine at least one solution for theta. Let's make sure that we're in radian mode, which we are. So we'll press secant sine 2/5. So one possibility for theta would be approximately 0.4115. But remember, sine theta is positive in both the first and second quadrants, and the calculator only gave us the one in the first quadrant. So let's go ahead and model this angle. Let's say this angle here is approximately 0.4115 radians. Well, the reference angle in the second quadrant would have the same sine function value. So let's go ahead and sketch a reference angle of 0.4115 radians in the second quadrant. So it might look something like this, where the reference angle right here is approximately 0.4115 radians. So the second possibility for theta would be this angle here. And to determine the measure of that angle, we can take pi radians, a half a revolution, and then subtract 0.4115. Again, this angle would be pi minus 0.4115 radians. So pi minus 0.4115 radians is approximately equal to 2.7301 radians. But we're not done, remember we have to solve for x. So we found theta, so now we'll perform a substitution back up here to determine the value of x. So one equation will be 3x is approximately equal to 0.4115, and then 3x is approximately equal to 2.7301. So to solve for x, we'll divide both sides of the equation by 3 for both equations. Let's go back to the calculator. We have 0.4115 divided by 3. So x is approximately 0.1372 radians. And the second solution x is approximately 0.9100. I hope you found this helpful.